was to be coming up playing against Pau, and you
I
were
knew
correct.
It. I
you
knew
were correct.
It. I knew it was the Wolf player, dude.
And he's actually playing the Palutena, not even playing the Olimar or. You know, I actually like the idea of going Palutena early, because Palutena is a good pools destroyer.
So I guess the buzz is the same control scheme for Rosa, because he always does buzz and then the first letter of which character.
Yeah, because for Olimar, he's hitting the C-Stick a lot.
He plays Buzzo for
his
that.
First smash attacks, and the other one's for tilt.
This one would normally be Buzz P, but I guess he went opted for Buzz R, which is to Buzz Rosa.
Yeah, Pao is just trying to land currently at the moment. He's doing a half decent job of not taking too much damage off of each interaction, but the Buzz is a slow burner. He likes to figure out how you react.
He'll dissect you real hard.
The moment he starts figuring out your natural habits on a regular basis, especially at the ledge, you're in for a rough time.
This Wolf, I've noticed, is already looking pretty good with not committing too early. He knows when to put the brakes on and really hold his ground, which is something you need to have as Wolf.
The fact he went for the up B instead of side B there.
If Wolf side B's, he can get clipped by that up smash.
Yeah, but he ain't making it back from that time. Yeah, it's very important. You have to constantly change things up, but can't change up that air train right there all the way to 45%. That, and this is what we didn't see in that last matchup, because Wolf wants to go airborne. He wants to short hop nairs. He wants to short up fair. He wants to close the gap on you and not really go for those dash attacks too much, except for like kill percent.
Pau would have gotten that that back air right there if he hadn't gotten hit by the explosive play. Mm-hmm.
I like that the Buzz just putting out these small hitboxes, just kind of consistently putting out one to two to three things and reading the fact that he's going to be aggressive on landing yet again with that forward smash, taking a 2-0 lead.
The Wings of Death coming in right there to really take out Pau. Pau doesn't look like a bad player by any metric. It's just unfortunate that you have to play against one of the best players in the game right now.
You always need to play almost like confusing, because you can't the same blueprint, like the same
if you
like,
try to play high mid level, it's not gonna work.
Yeah,
you gotta play low level.
And he's been doing a good job of kind of changing it up a bit, but it's where his defense has been like the lacking part so far. Every time he puts something out, he's been getting called out on a lot of anti-airs by the Buzz. And the Buzz is just holding shield consistently, not getting grabbed pretty much at all, staying on the move perfectly, finally getting called out on the jump though with that back air.
There's one thing that the Buzz is great at, it's two things. Actually, two things that the Buzz is
three
one
things.
One is picking up on your advantage state, or your rather disadvantage state. He's going to be able to punish you accordingly every single time. If he's going to pay especially attention to what you do when you're at disadvantage. He's going to try and force you in situations that force you to mix up how you do, so he knows every possible route you're going to take. Another great thing I like to see is his patterning. His technicality and his skill is really, really good.
Probably going to go for a jump read right there. He does so well at conditioning opponents.
It's ridiculous how good his conditioning is.
And like now that he's gotten him to jump a few times, see, he backs off looking for potential roll there. He didn't give it to him, but he's at 0% with a stock up. It's okay to go for that situation.
And look at how reactionary he's been playing towards the ledge. Notice how he hasn't been throwing out down tilts brazenly. He's been really waiting for the correct options to rise and stuff. And it's been paying off in spades for the Buzz.
Yeah, just like being able to maneuver around a lot of Pau's hitboxes. You want so badly to close the gap. But the thing is, if you're not forcing the Buzz into an uncomfortable position on defense, then you maybe need to reset.
Right.
Go back to the other side of stage. Just like don't maybe not throw out lasers because he was reflecting them, but just kind of like fake potential movement options and take that moment to figure out what's going on. Because the Buzz is a naturally aggressive player, like contrary to popular belief, after he figures you out. So if you can maybe figure out what he's looking for beforehand, then you might be in a better spot.
He goes in mad hard.
Going into game number two here, we're going to be going to Yoshi's. Actually, no, never mind. I thought I saw a check mark there. We'll be going to wherever they happen to point out to us, because they did not click on the pad. That's okay. Buzz looked extremely solid in that first game there, only taking one stock loss on a jump read, not taking any damage pretty much at all on that second stock.
Here we go, though. Taking the battlefield, I do like this pick for Pau a lot. I'd like to see a lot more empty hops in place from Pau. Just catching any sort of approach option that the Buzz does. Also, if the Buzz misses, you gotta capitalize for sure. You who knows when you're gonna get that window again. You really need to know how to push your advantage state a lot.
And I like what Pau's doing now. Like he's playing just enough out of range. He's trying to see when is the Buzz gonna approach me. But problem is the Buzz hasn't really needed to because he's not feeling too stressed so far. But I like the change of game plan.
No, he just put Pow in these like very, very scary situations. And he gets the down smash right there. That was perfect. Yeah, DeBuzz doing that rising explosive flame again, and Pow catching onto it. Wolf's low profile is amazing for catching those kinds of
high. And that's all you needed, but he forced DeBuzz's hand, made him have to approach, and as soon as DeBuzz had to approach, he blitzed him hard and immediately closed that gap.
Okay, starting off with the combo right there. I'm always enamored by how well DeBuzz does. With Palutena, you have to drag them back into you. You have to slowly wade them in and out. That's a combo I don't really see many characters that have moves that can combo like that, where you drag them back into your combo every single time.
One of my favorite things to see out of like high-end top players is when they lose a stock like that, their rebuttal. Like, yeah. They get so almost like upset at you. Like,
they
how dare you take that from me?
And,
like, the intensity just goes to another level. Like, you thought you figured me out. Now, I'm changing it up completely again. The difference is, though, that Pow actually has him at kill percent this time on meeting him on the second stock.
All right. Okay. Now, one thing I like to see Pow doing is reacting a bit more when Buzz is coming off the ledge. Pow, all that happened because Pow went for a random aerial and just tried to get some sort of hard read. You're going to want to react. Most of ledge trapping is reactions, and it requires 100% of your focus. And now my man is getting laddered into oblivion right now. No jump
A good
left.
Frame trap as well to force him back to the ledge with that fair. DeBuzz intentionally left a couple jumps free a few times. So he was able to close out that last stock on that. Now Pow is in a spot where it's like, well, I've getting called out on everything. How do I change this up? Do I approach really heavy? But because he's approaching so heavily right now, DeBuzz is walking away with a really good lead. You see he's whipping a lot of attacks now too.
Another thing I'd like to see Pow doing is try going for some two frames at ledge. Palutena's recovery has no hitbox on it.
Yeah, I like the narrow out of shield there, just like not trying to go for the grab. He's been whipping them. He's got the right idea. And then reset there too. Don't try and land right on top of the buzz. Just get good stage positioning. You're at kill percent right now. There's no point to do it.
I also noticed that Pow isn't catching DeBuzz's landings as well as he could have. Up smash, especially at this percent, can scoop up quite nicely. He's been going for these F smashes at an unsafe distance. If he gets shield grabbed, he can get shield grabbed a lot.
And he jumped yet again. Now he's forced to have to go.
Dead.
Yeah, he had no other option there. He had to either pull to side B early or just land exactly where he was going, and that was all she wrote. Good, clean. Really well dissected with DeBuzz there on that two
spot. DeBuzz's play makes me feel like I just took a shower because it's so fresh.